Hi, welcome to my channel again. Today I'm showing you my new project. It's a Betafpv Pavo20 and Runcam Night Eagle HD camera for it. So it will be a black and white but night vision camera. As I live in Sweden, so we have really dark for half the year. So it will be nice to have a drone that you can fly even when it's starting to get dark outside. So I thought I would do an unboxing of this, and I'm still waiting for some parts, soldering iron and some other stuff so I can build it together. So let's see if I can get the proper unboxing here. So you can see. So let's take a look at the camera first. So this is the Runcam Night Eagle HD, like I said. First thing you get is the camera itself and the connection manual or the guide on how to connect it. Here's the camera itself with the Runcam link VTX. And this is the one I will have the soldering connections to get it working. I ordered another one. So this here is the Runcam Night Eagle HD. So it's a tiny little night vision camera that only films in black and white. So it will be a bit different kind of drone to fly with. But in the dark, you don't really need to see other than the objects you're hopefully not crashing into. And in the box, you also get the antenna. Not sure if this will work with the Pavo20 I got. We'll have to see. A connector cable and some screws to put it in place. So this will be a fun project build, I think. I was kind of looking forward to build a drone from scratch, actually. But when I tried to look into it and see what I was supposed to get and so on, it would be a lot more expensive to buy it in parts than to buy the drone already built like I did now. So let's see. So this is the Pavo20, like I said. You get a LED strip already in the package. So you can put the LED strip around the drone to make it look awesome in the air. Here we have some propellers. And it's a USB-C connector adapter. Then we get some screws and small antennas and some kind of mounting plate. Let's look at those tiny little antennas that come with. I think these are meant for if you go with the O3 unit, DJI's O3 system instead of the one I got, then you can put on the small antennas for it. Then we get a frame to put the camera on. And then the drone itself. Let's see if we can get it out. And already battery strap connected to it. Small XT30 connector. And a connector for the camera. This one will be need to be changed as this is meant for the O3 unit, I think. So I will have to take the one I have to for the camera and solder it on. And here's a connector too. Maybe for the lights. The LED lights. Does look really good, the quality. And nothing more. The card. And for the support. Looks cool, so hopefully I can get everything together when it's time. I also bought some extra propellers, more propellers, and another LED light. I'm not sure what color the one that comes with the drone is, if it's a white one or a blue one or what it is. But we'll have to see. And also an extra frame, as it didn't cost much more to just get the extra frame, a couple of bucks more. So if I would crash it, I can just change it. Or if I want to, I can order another flight controller and an O3 unit maybe, and I would have two drones. Yeah, motors too. So it's a little bit of a build. Also got batteries. These Tattoo R-Line 650 milliamp hour batteries. I think this look quite big at the moment when I'm looking at the drone, so it might be too big of a battery. But we'll have to see. Yeah, might need a different strap at least. I will need a bigger battery strap, maybe, to be able to use these batteries. Or do you have other tips? If you do, please do leave a comment on how would you do. It's a big ass connector. Well, so just waiting for the soldering iron and a couple other things to arrive. I will make a video of me soldering it, then I have to configure it to work with the DJI remote too. As I don't have this is a ELRS model, so I could get another controller. But at the moment, I was going to connect it with the DJI FPV controller too. But I need to reconfigure the flight controller to do that. So I'll have to check a couple of videos and so on to get everything. Yeah. Thank you for watching, and if you want to follow, you will see the rest of the progress. I will probably post it in a week or two when I have come a bit further with the build. Yeah, thanks.